Hey, it's Jamie. So I'm back with my first tutorial. I'm so excited. I hope it is as great as I think it's gonna be. So today we're gonna be working on these
crushed velvet
high waist, kind of like tights, a little mid cap action going on. They make me feel really great. They make my butt feel really great. So I just want y'all to experience that too, you know? Okay, so for this tutorial, you will need your sewing machine, fabric scissors, measuring tape, pins, matching thread, crushed velvet, and a pair of pants or tights, skinny leg that fit you pretty well. Stretch pants because you're using stretch fabric. I'm not using matching thread because I didn't really have any of this color today. But it'll be okay. I'll let you know how to figure out how much fabric you need. So before we start, we need to take the only two measurements you're gonna need for this video. So, you're going to take your waist where you want the pants to sit. My waist is like 25 and a half inches. So, you need to write that down. And then, from your waist to where you want the pants to end. And for me, it is right under my calf. And that'll be 27 inches. So, from your waist, you need to subtract 3 inches, and for your length, you need to add an inch. Okay, so now that you've written those measurements down, you can grab the pants and the fabric, and I'll show you how to cut out your pieces so that you can make your pants. The first thing you need to do is fold your pants towards the inside so that the butt is out. And then take your length measurement, which for me was the 27 inches plus one, so 28 inches, and measure from the waist to that point on the pants you're using. And fold your pants up at that point. So now I'm going to set my fabric up so that I could cut it out. For this, I'm not actually going to trace it on the fabric because I can just use these pants. It'll be easier because sometimes when you trace on stretch, it kind of like bunches up and it's not good. So let me put these pants on the side and I'll take a section and that's just wide enough for the pants to fit and fold it, making sure that the stretch goes this way. So the stretch would need to go horizontally on the pants and then place your pants on the fold with the outside edges on the fold and cut about 1 inch straight around your pants. You're going to do this 2 times, so that's going to give you both of your pants legs. I did use tights the first time I made these, and these pants fit me pretty close to the way the tights I own fit. But you can use any pair of pants as long as you like their fit to make these. Okay, so that's one. Instead of using the pants to cut the other section, I'm going to fold my fabric over and use the same one that I just cut. fabric you need. Definitely depends on what size you are, how tall you are, and I'll put the information about how much fabric you need in the description. Okay. So now we've cut out 2 pants legs. You can see here. So I'm going to put these to the side. So our next step is to make the waistband. My waist was about 25 inches, so I subtracted 3, that'll give me 22, and I'm going to divide that by 2. I'll put the math that you need to do in the description box. When I divide that by 2, I get 11. So I fold the remaining fabric over with the stretch still going horizontally, and I use my measurement, which is the 11, and I go across. I measure what would be 11 inches. I make sure that my fold is 11 inches. And then I measure a 4-inch strip and I cut that out. Now, if you need to, you can fold the fabric so the right sides are facing together, and that way you can draw a straight line on the wrong side to do this part, just to make sure you get a straight line. So now you should have a waist piece. Just have 2 leg pieces. I always try to cut everything out before we go to the sewing machine. So the last thing you need would be to cut a strip about, let's say, 18 inches long of the fabric, an inch wide, going with the direction of the stretch, the same way we've done for everything else. Okay, and you can put your scraps on the side. For this piece, I'm cutting the selvage off because that part won't stretch as well as other parts. So this will be the bow. So you pull it. You don't really have to do much sewing to this. You just pull it and put it to the side. You're gonna fold down your pants legs right side together. And you're gonna stitch from the crotch to the bottom of your pants. And you're gonna repeat for each leg. I do recommend using a zigzag stitch. If you have a serger, use your serger. Because with a stretch material, a zigzag stitch will give it more leeway. If you use a straight stitch, you will hear it popping as it stretches when you put it on. So I'm gonna take this to the machine, stitch with a 1/4-inch seam allowance, and then I'm gonna come back. I stitched both of my pant legs. I used my snips to get rid of any extra thread that was on them, and I turned one onto the right side. So the pant leg that is on the right side, with the crushed velvet facing up, you're gonna insert that into the other pant leg.
Just give it a little shake. Then you're gonna line up the seam of each one. Straighten it out a little bit. And you're gonna pin, placing the first pin at the seam.
straight up and down the sides, making sure that you do not pin the opening where your waist goes. So this is how it should look. Now we're going to rest that to the side. We're going to take the waistband that you cut, fold it hamburger style, and place some pins. So now that you've pinned the raw edges and you've pinned the crotch, take it to your sewing machine and sew with a 1/4 inch seam allowance with a zigzag stitch, and then come back. I stitched the inseam of the leg, I guess. I don't like the word crotch, and the waistband. So I'm just double checking to make sure I took all the pins out and using my snips to get rid of the red. Okay, so your next step is to turn everything on the right side. Turn your waistband on the right side. Fold it in half with wrong sides together. And with all of the raw edges, that's the edges that aren't sewn, in the same direction, insert your pants into the waistband. Like this. Pin the 3 layers of seam to the back seam of your pants. You can now gauge where the front seam would land on the waistband. And the 2 sides. If you need to, put more pins going around the outside of it, but I think that should be fine, and you could just stretch the waistband to accommodate for any extra fabric you need to stitch. So you stitch the waistband and now fold the bottom in about 1 inch. Pin it in place. On each leg, and take it to your sewing machine and hem the pants and sew the waist. The waist is in place, my hem is in place. If it's a little bunched up, it's fine because once you put it on, it'll all stretch out. So a step I didn't show just now was I took that strip we cut earlier, I found the middle point of it, and I found the middle front of the waistband, and I just backstitched a few times over it and pull it a little bit more to keep it curled, and then tie it up. Just snip it to even it up, and you're done. Just double check to make sure you didn't leave any pins and that you snipped all the extra thread, and yeah. This is the finished product. Still cute. Still like my black ones better. I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. I hope it was a good one. Everything that I told you I would leave in the description is going to be down there, so just check it out and stay tuned to see what I do next week. If you have any questions about anything in this tutorial or the pants, feel free to ask in the comments section and like and subscribe to my channel.